We'd like to solve the differential equation. Delta y over delta x is equal to the negative ax plus by divided by bx plus cy. So the first thing to note is that you need to cross-multiply. Cross-multiplying gives you bx plus cy delta y is equal to the negative ax plus by delta x. Okay, then you can add on both sides. So you're gonna basically add. You're going to add this and delta x, of course. Right, so you will get ax plus by delta x plus bx plus cy delta y is equal to 0. Dividing both sides by delta x, you will get ax plus by plus bx plus cy delta y over delta x, right? Because you're dividing both sides by delta x is equal to 0. And as you can see, this is the familiar form, ax plus by plus bx plus cy, y prime, right, is equal to 0, right, because delta y over delta x is the y prime. So now this is the familiar form that you're going to use in order to determine whether or not the differential equation is exact, all right? So basically the form of this is m function as a function of x and y plus the n function as a function of x and y times y prime is equal to 0. Right. So what it means that the m function is this part, ax plus by, and the n function as a function of x and y is the function multiplied to the y prime, bx plus cy. So now what we're going to do, in order to determine whether or not the equation is exact, we need to differentiate the m function with respect to y. So the derivative of the m function with respect to y must be equal to the derivative of the n function with respect to x in order for equation to be exact. Right, so let's see. So the derivative of the m with respect to y, and we're talking about partial derivative, right? So that means the first term will be 0 because it involves the variable x, which is in this case a constant when we're talking about partial derivative, right? So you're only differentiating this pretty much. And well, you're differentiating both, but the first is gone, it becomes 0. But the second one becomes b, right? Because the derivative of y is 1, right? So 1 times b is b. Now, does that equal to the partial derivative of the n function with respect to x? Well, let's see. So we know that the partial derivative of the n function with respect to x is going to be b. The derivative of x is 1. 1 times b is b. But the cy is a constant in this case because we're finding the partial derivative of the n function with respect to x, right? So cy becomes 0. So indeed, look what happens. Indeed, we have exact equation, right? Because we found that the value is indeed equal. It's equal to b for two partial derivatives of different functions. So now, If it's an exact equation, then there is the phi function. Okay, such that the derivative of the phi function with respect to x is equal to the m function, and the derivative of the phi function with respect to y is going to be the n function. Right? So what does it tell us? Now let's find the phi function from the fact that the partial derivative of the phi function with respect to x is equal to m. So we can just integrate the m function with respect to x, and then we'll find the phi function. Right? So where's the m function? So we'll put our m and n here so that we can easily refer to them at any time we want. Right? So let's integrate. So the phi function will be the integral of the m function with respect to x. Right? So this is what we want, ax plus by. Write that a little clearer. With respect to x, right, is going to be the dx integral. Right, so what is that going to be? Using the power rule, for the first one, we will have a over 2x squared plus byx, right, because the by is constant. We're talking about dx integral, right, so we're just having the x multiplied to it, plus a constant. How do we express a constant? We can express a constant because it's a dx integral, right? So the dx integral means that we can have a function in terms of y, right? Because a function in terms of y, when it comes to the dx integral, will be a constant. So we can indicate it as h of y. H as a function h as a function of y, right? So now that we found that, we can set this part, the derivative of the phi function with respect to y. Okay, so set the derivative of the phi function with respect to y, the partial derivative, that is, set it to the n function. What does that give us? This, what is the derivative of the phi function with respect to y? The derivative of the phi function with respect to y is going to be, we need to differentiate this one, right? We need to differentiate the phi function we just found with respect to y, right? So this becomes zero, right? Because we're talking about partial derivative with respect to y now, right? So this is zero because this deals with x and everything else. It's all constant. And then this one has the y, so we'll have bx, right? Because the derivative of y is 1, right? 1 times bx is bx. Plus, and now this is a function of y, right? So differentiating this will give us h prime of y, right? That's pretty easy. That's straightforward. And now we set this equal to the n function. The n function is here. Bx plus cy. So what does it tell us? Notice that these two guys are the same. So it means that the h prime of y is equal to cy, right? This part is equal to that. So now integrating, we get h as a function of y is equal to the antiderivative of this, right? The antiderivative of cy, right? So that's going to be, and notice that it's going to be a dy integral, right? Because we're integrating this function as a function of y, so it's going to be c over 2y squared plus a constant. Now this constant can be omitted, right? Because the differential equation that we're trying to solve, it will work for every solution. Right, there's no particular solution, so we don't need a general solution, right? So we can omit the constant, we don't need it. Right? So basically the phi function is going to be a over 2x squared plus byx plus the h of y, which we just found is just the first term, c over 2y squared. Right? So that means that the solution to this original differential equation is a over 2x squared, right, we're just copying the right side, plus byx plus c over 2y squared is equal to k, capital K. I'm going to put capital K for now. Now, why is there a constant? Remember that when you're trying to solve this part here, right, when you try, when you're trying to solve this differential equation that we found by rewriting the original one, you're ultimately, if you integrate both sides, you will get a constant on the right side, right? This is why that we have a constant K there. So why is it a capital K? Notice that we're not using the C because there's already a C constant, which is a different type of constant. We need to multiply both sides of the equation by 2, right? Multiply both sides by 2. So you will get the solution ax squared plus 2byx, right? Because we're multiplying both sides by 2 to get rid of the fractions here, right? Plus cy squared is equal to 2 multiplies the k as well, right? So why don't we just put it as a lowercase k because it's a different constant now. Right? So that will be your final solution. Okay, this is going to be the solution of the original differential equation that we were given. Thanks so much for watching. Hope this was helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.